Welcome back, everybody. The History Guy here. Time to continue on playing the American campaign in Ultimate Admiral Age of Sail. If you did not see the first, 12 episodes or so of this, you can click on a link in the description below. It'll take you all the way back to episode one. You can see how we got to this point. We are on to a new chapter. I believe at the moment this is the last chapter that is available in this campaign, but we'll find out. And maybe by the time we get to the end of this one, they'll have updated more. We've got two new battles we can fight, the Battle of Turtle Gut Inlet and the Battle of Block Island, which is the one that we're going to take on today. They're both sea battles. There's also a side mission right here that we may take on. I'm not sure yet. But let's look at the situation at the moment. We've got the HMS Lennox, which we just captured. It's going to cost a ton to be able to buy it from the Admiralty. I'm just not sure if we've even got what is necessary to make that happen. We're going to send to the Admiralty. That's going to get us to 38. Still not enough. I'm guessing 40 is probably what we need. So if we go in and sell some weapons, we may get what we need to make this happen. So let's take a look here at land weapons. I don't really need any of these. That gained me 1 point. These will probably get me the other point that I need. That gets me up to 42. Let's see if that's enough to buy this thing from the Admiralty. It is. Excellent. Let's add it to the fleet. We've now got a 68-gun ship, which we are definitely going to change the name of. Now, I've got a patron that requested a name, so I'm going to go ahead and go with that for this particular ship. So, Peter, this one's for you. We got to repair it first. He requested a Hussar, which is going to be American in this case. Most of the patrons have their ships in the British campaign, which we will get back to as soon as they have it updated and they add more missions to it. Right now, we just don't have any more that we can take on. So you can see here, we can actually upgrade these to the 6-pounder. So let's go ahead and do that. So the USS Hussar, we need to add some crew. This is going to get crazy expensive. We're probably going to have to sell some more things to be able to get what we need on this. We're also going to need to repair the Revenge and add to her crew. Those are probably the two we're going to take. Man, it's going to take a lot of money to do this. So let me see what I can do to make this happen. Because we've got to add 5 officers as well. All right, now we're in business. We're going to add 516 crew to this ship. Now we've got to finish assigning our other officers. We're just going to take the best available. Not in the reserve, but rather recruit new ones because the reserve officers kind of stink, honestly. I haven't seen my guy appear yet. These ones in red are all folks who are... If you have the Admiral edition of the game, you get to choose it in-game character. That's why you get something like Destructor Maximus. History Guy will appear at some point, though I haven't seen it just yet. Let me go back and look and make sure that this is the best officer I can get in this case. I believe it is. Okay, so we're good there. Let's take a look at the Revenge. Revenge is good as well. I think those are the two ships we're going to be able to take into this battle. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. All right, so here we go. I spent all that money building up the Hussar, and it's a 300-point ship, so I can't even take it into this mission. So instead, we get to use the Revenge and the Virginia. So it looks like I spent all those points for nothing, but that's what happens sometimes. I probably should have gone in and checked that out first, but we should be able to take this mission on with these two ships. We returned back from success raid to the Bahamas. We captured a few prizes and traveling back. We have scouting formation where there are 2 columns on flanks and prizes with protecting ships in the middle. We hope to capture more British ships. Oh, this is a nighttime battle. Is that what's going on here? Our right flank detected a sail on the horizon. It's a British frigate. We are going to attack the ship. It's the HMS Glasgow. Hey, my family lived in Glasgow, so this is kind of exciting to capture that one. We must protect our prizes, carrying weapons and ammunition from the Bahamas. They must continue their way to New London. We must avoid an encounter with the British squadron at Newport. All right, so there's a lot going on here. We got to protect this whole squadron here. We just got to get them all safely there and just come up here and deal with the Glasgow as best we can. Stay on this side if possible. Let's get the Virginia up there as well. We've also got this little ship here, the Fly, with 28 men on board. So what are the ones? Walrus must reach safe zone, and Chelmer must reach safe zone. Okay, so those are the two. We just got to keep them safe, keep them out of the way. Not a problem. Glasgow's got to kind of go into the wind here, so... Of course, we'll probably end up seeing more British ships show up at some point. Okay. Man, I sure could have used that big ship on this one. Alright, Virginia's going to make first contact. We're going to try to nail this guy's sails right off the bat if we can. Somebody suggested maybe trying to aim at the mast. I'm going to try that and see how it works out. And it looks like it's working so far. You can see we did some pretty significant damage to his sails with the chain shot. I'm going to try to do that again here. He's a little out of range now. I'm going directly into the wind at the moment, so I'm actually pretty content to sit right where I am. As long as I'm engaging Glasgow, that means my ships that need to get to freedom can do so. So far, so good on the sails. And he's not really doing much to me, so that's the better news. And he's starting to get a little closer on me now. We can just take that mast out altogether. He's got 44 guns. Yeah, it bounced off. We need to get revenge over here. Yeah, that's not working. Come on, Revenge, get there. Keep hitting those sails. If nothing else, I'm going to prevent Glasgow from being able to pursue the targets that it needs in order for me to lose this fight. So if I accomplish nothing else with the Glasgow but that, it'll be worth it. Where's Virginia? Or where's Revenge? Revenge is getting there. It's just taking a while. There are my two ships that need to get out of here. Walrus is one of them. Send these two that way as well. Chelmer is right there. No, I don't want you to go that way. You need to go this way and get out of there. Oh yeah, baby. Take those sails down. Glasgow is pretty much stuck in the water at this point. Come on, where are my other ships? Let's get up there, Revenge. Looks like my first ships are getting to safety. And now two more British ships have arrived. The Uther and the Yeoman. And they're big ones. In the meantime, a couple of mine are getting to safety. Other ones, not so much, at least not yet. Now, if we put them on AI, they decide to go fight, and that's not what we want at all. Let's go ahead and switch to some solid shot now. Although this distance, probably not likely to do a lot of damage. Come on, Revenge, get there. We should be able to outmaneuver him now. Try to get him behind. These are gonna bounce. Yeah, everything's bouncing. My guns just aren't big enough. I'm not entirely sure what the Wasp is going to accomplish by being here, but it's here nonetheless. Oh, Glasgow just earned a star. In fact, Wasp, why don't you just shoo, so to speak. Maybe we just keep going after the mast. wasp becomes a target, I suppose. Alright, we gotta use solid. So does Virginia at this point. Go for the mast. Hold off. Okay, now. Alright, these other ships are coming for me. That's good news. Because that means they're not going for these two. Which are so slow. See if maybe we change the angle. Maybe we can get them to go a little faster. Alright, there we got a hit on the mast. That's what we're after. We're going against the wind now, though. Hey, there we go. We got the rigging shock. We took out that mast. Beautiful. Do the same with the second one now. Gotta be careful I don't shoot at myself here. Oh, Virginia's taking some losses. We gotta be careful with them. Got two more ships about to arrive. Meanwhile, Walrus and Chelmer slowly making their way to safety. Oh, Glasgow's up to 2 stars now. Wasp, you're gonna just have to be my cannon fodder for this one. That close to Luther. How are we doing, boys? Is about to be out of action. Oh, Virginia's taking a lot of casualties. Try to get out of here now. There, we just took out the other mast on the Glasgow. Just have the rear one left. See if we can get revenge out of here. It's really just a matter of getting those other two ships to safety. If it had just been the Glasgow, we'd have been in good shape. Last mass. That's it, yeoman. Go after revenge. Luther's coming, or Uther is coming this way now. just have to make a run for it. I think that's how this one's gonna have to go. We're just gonna have to hope we can get out of here without losing the ship. It doesn't matter which direction I run. The Wasp is sunk. That's not a big deal. It wasn't one of my ships anyway. Really wish I could have taken Glasgow. Alright, so this mission didn't go quite as well as I would have liked. In hindsight, I've learned a few things. I think if I went back and replayed it, I would know what to do better, but the good news is all of my ships will have survived. Virginia's going to get to safety, and it's going to come out of here a 2-star experience ship. So that's nice, because though it'll be expensive to replenish the crew, that experience gained will be very, very helpful. We got all ships to safety. We completed the mission. Didn't capture anything this time around, but that's quite all right. Let's go ahead and see where we stand after this one. All right, my two ships are safely to the safe zone, and that is a victory. Not a pretty one, but a victory. Looks like losses are relatively light on each side, even though he definitely had me in terms of the number of crew. What I probably should have done is just abandoned a couple of those smaller ships, loaded those men up onto my other ones, and done it that way. I don't know. There's a lot of things I would have done differently if I had that one to do over again. But hopefully we get to take our big ship, the Hussar, into this next mission. We're going to kind of take a quick peek at that mission and see exactly what we can do. All right, so Battle of Block Island, we gained 12,500 money. Plus 400 sea service, 38 musket and sword bayonets. Those are always good. Plus 1 experience, plus 9 to our prestige. Let's go ahead and get a quick preview of this battle. I really hope that there's somewhere that's got room for 300 so I can throw this big ship into this fight. And that would be a big fat no. So, I don't know, maybe we can at least send it on the side mission? I guess we'll take a look at that as well. So, 240 is the max on this one. So, once again, we're going to be taking our smaller ships into the fight. So, once again, it was kind of pointless to me to spend all that money fitting that ship and getting it ready to go when I'm not able to use it. All right, let's look at the side mission real quick. Only 100 on that one, so... if we send Margaret, it's only 37% chance of success. So that's where we're at. I guess we just get refit and ready for the next battle. Let me know your thoughts about all of that. There's definitely some things I would do differently. I think it's going to be interesting to go back and replay the American campaign once it's complete. Because there's a lot I would do differently now with the experience that I have. So use the comment section below. Let me know your thoughts. It'll be a few days before you see another episode in this campaign since I'm going to be out of town. But we'll get back to it as soon as we can. Thanks for watching.